Hi, I'm Jack Barnes, President and CEO of People's United Bank. I'm here in the center of Westport, a city many cultural institutions and successful artists call home. People's United Bank is proud to support the communities where we live and work. That's why we're supporting CPTV and the many Connecticut cultural treasures they will be featuring over the coming months. Look for stories each week featuring cultural treasures in your neighborhood.
If you want to get a feel for what it must have been like to be living and working in the late 1700s and 1800s, this is the place that you can actually experience that.
It tells the story of how people have come together over time and argued and agreed and fought and made up.
This building I see as one of the few actual physical connections to the past.
The old State House can really use the past to help people imagine the future.
Part of what I think makes the old State House such a Connecticut treasure is that it represents our earlier history. Up until 1873, Connecticut had two capitals, Hartford and New Haven. And yet this building is the only state capital from that earlier period that's still in existence.
When this building was built, it was really built as sort of a temple on the hill by the architect Charles Bulfinch, so that the old State House really looked down on the river, and the river was the important part of the city at that time, not Main Street.
This building really has been the site of so many important debates of freedom, who's free, who can vote, who can participate in our civic life, and those stories, those events happened here. And I think that's why this building is so important.
Some people feel it was the launching point for democracy in America. It was on the site of the old State House that Thomas Hooker delivered the sermon that became the Fundamental Orders, which really is the basis for consent of the people. The laws passed here, the ideas that were debated here, affected everybody, no matter where they lived.
Over the 83 years we were a state capital, there were so many significant debates going on about who was free. Slavery existed in Connecticut until 1848. The beginnings of the Amistad hearings took place here. Prudence Crandall's final trial took place here. The beginning of the fight for women to have rights. Isabella Beecher Hooker petitioned the General Assembly for the right of married women to hold on to their own property.
Connecticut's Old State House is a place where people can come to learn about history, but it's also a place where you can just have a good time. We have a wonderful exhibit in our Mortenson Gallery, which talks about the history of Hartford in a very colorful way. We have a giant fire truck down there. We also have Mark Twain's bicycle. Lots of other things for people to explore. And we have a Museum of Curiosities, and it has things like a two-headed calf, and all kinds of really different things. Plus a Lego replica of the old State House. When you're here, you're also going to hear how those things sort of fit together and get a complete story of what the building is and what it means to Connecticut.
The old State House had actually all three branches of government that met inside of it, and this room is where the judicial branch would have met. So a number of very important court trials took place in this room, and any time there was a particularly scintillating court case, this place would have been packed. Probably the most famous court case that was held here was the Amistad trial. The Africans were like celebrities, when the court trial actually took place, the issue that they were discussing was whether or not the Africans should be considered slaves.
Even if people don't come here knowing a lot about the Amistad trials, they will learn about that and learn about its importance in Connecticut and American history. We have the House of Representatives, which is a Victorian room.
The 13th Amendment, which was the amendment that officially abolished slavery, would have been ratified here by the Connecticut General Assembly in May of 1865.
And we have a Senate, which is stunning. It's got an original Gilbert Stuart portrait of George Washington.
This building has a strong connection to Washington. Washington visited the site during the American Revolution to talk strategy with Count Rochambeau. The old State House has always been at the center. It's been at the hub of Hartford and of Connecticut. And we continue to play that role through our public programs.
The mission of the old State House is to really take history and help people feel inspired by it. I hope that when people come here, they get a sense of all of the people who have come before them. People in a particular place who made decisions to take action to make life better.
Funding provided by CPTV, the State of Connecticut, Melinda and Paul Sullivan, Connecticut Humanities Council, Connecticut's Old State House, Connecticut General Assembly, Joint Committee on Legislative Management, and People's United Bank, what know-how can do.